February the 2nd, another two black people were killed in Somalia. The 1st of February, six black people were killed in Niger. Go down the list, the last, now the 30th of January, eight black people were killed in Nigeria by hate groups. I mean, there is not a single day that goes by, literally, not a single day that goes by, that innocent people of color, not talking about abortion, we're talking about hate groups. There's not a single day goes by that people of color aren't being killed by hate groups. But it turns out that these hate groups are Muslim hate groups, Islamic hate groups, so they get a pass. What are your thoughts, Barry?
Sad as it is to say, Ken, the news is filtered through political agendas. The perfect example of that is the United Nations. In the past, say, 10 years, if you combine all of the UN resolutions about discrimination, hatred, and murder in the Muslim world, of all the countries, and I'm talking billions of people, and all the resolutions, and then you add on top of those the resolutions about North Korea with their concentration camps, maybe killing as many as a million people over the last 20 years. You add in Syria and the Muslims slaughtering Muslims and Christians, and in Iran and Iraq and Niger and Libya, country after country after country. And you add up all the resolutions to protect those people and balance them against the resolutions against the state of Israel. It's something like 100 resolutions for the state against the state of Israel against one for the whole rest of the world, where we're talking about millions and millions of people being enslaved, sold as slaves, especially in Africa. The African slave trade is outstandingly robust. Why? Because it's legal under Islam, and all the people imprisoned around the world. Nobody at the UN seems to care, Ken, because it's not supportive of their political agenda. You can kill all the Africans you want by Muslims. That's not even a statistic that gets reported, period.
What is their political agenda? You know, my presumption is it's globalism. Whatever advances that agenda, that paradigm of globalism, they're for it. That's their moral directive is, okay, is this good for or against globalism? If it's for it, okay, let's do it. What do you think?
Well, I got to be honest. I'm not a big fan of the United Nations. I think it's a kangaroo court run by kangaroos. I mean, I sort of feel bad because it's insulting. Kangaroos are adorable, cute creatures, and I don't mean to demean them, so I apologize to the kangaroo community. But that's literally what the United Nations is. The unaligned block numerically is greater than the whole rest of the United Nations. So all of Western civilization gets the same vote country for country as these goofball dictatorships where they don't even have elections, where you come to power with a gun, you stay in power with a whole lot of guns, and you leave power when you get killed and the next guy takes over, i.e. North Korea. So what happens is they vote down anything having to, look, when you have a human rights council led by a human rights abuser of millions of people, isn't it time to just leave? Why even give an organization like this any legitimacy is my point. And
why don't we just leave the United Nations?
I'm with you, bro. I get out. Save the money. Give it to people in the United States that fought for this country that are living on the streets today because no one will take care of them. That's what really bothers me. We have to have a stupid debate about letting in millions of people undocumented with no visible means of support. And we've got how many homeless in America that we could take care of with a little tiny minuscule part of the budget and start with the veterans first.
Yeah.
You can find Barry Nussbaum at AmericanTruthProject.org, or the simple way to do it is findbarry.com, and it takes you right to the website.